There's been a basketball bouncing in New York for years. The game really got going in the 1920s. The New York Wrens. The first all-black team played up here on 138th Street and Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Boulevard. That set things up for what was about to become of New York City basketball. Holcomb Rucker, a man who worked for the Parks Department, started a basketball tournament in 1950. By the time the 60s hit, the tournament had gotten so big that the gang's baddest hoopers were coming uptown just about every day. Wilt, Kareem, Dr. J, and the local legends were getting their chance to show out against the pros. Dudes climbed fences, sat in trees, packed the park until it was standing room only. New York? It had become the mecca for basketball. Before Kareem was Kareem, he was Luke. And before Lou could play up at the park, he had to get his game right at St. Nick's Park in Manhattan. Parks all over the city started to follow in Rucker's footsteps. A couple years went by, games spread like wildfire. Kareem once said that Earl Manigo was the best he had ever played against. He was only 6'1", but he had trampoline bounce. Before Pearl Washington was a star at Syracuse, he was infamous at Kingdom. Nobody could stay in front of him. And everything Pearl did in Harlem, Gauchos was doing in the Bronx. Gauchos was a spot for Rod Strickland, Chris Mullin, Mark Jackson, and Ed Pinckney in the 80s. It was a basketball haven in the Bronx, and it helped guide young talented hoopers straight to D1 programs and to the league. A few years after Pearl did his damage, Kenny Anderson was using that creativity in his work at Left Rack. He'd weave in and out of defenses, sliding into any spot he wanted to get to on the court. And out in Coney Island, Stephon Marbury wasn't that far away, perfecting a combination of speed, handles, and passion that the city had never seen before. And his little cousin Sebastian was somewhere close by too, watching a new style of play being developed. Faster, meaner, more original. And they all wanted to play here at the Garden. The blinding lights, the curved ceilings, the energy flowed through the building. I mean, you can feel it. And it was around the same time that Anthony Mason and those dudes at West 4th Street were solidifying the cage as New York's next great court. Today, there's a new era. The last couple of summers have been playing out like movies up at Dyckman Park. People filled the stands like Rucker back in the day. The hottest park in the country. It's the spot for the first ever Slam Summer Classic, bringing 20 of the best high school ball players to the red carpet of street ball.